No, she's not dead. Nor is she going to die. Get out of my way!
Hannah!
What?
I miss him too.
I don't care. Find something useful to do. There's still a body in our front yard. Why don't you start there? With some shovels. I'm going to get you two back.
I was waiting outside your door for a while before I knocked. I wanted to make sure you were decent.
I know. I could hear your weight slightly shifting the floor. You have a tendency to lean on your left leg, and your breathing is really shallow compared to most.
Impressive. You're like a mouse.
I'd say a wolf, my lord.
Is that why everyone could hear you howling to the moon last night?
Why didn't you just have your guards come and fetch me? Shouldn't you be doing your royal duties or something, like terrorizing a village, stealing the girls, and keeping them as slaves?
Ah, touchy. Here I was, trying to be nice, bearing gifts.
Usually, people don't refer to entrapment as a sincere bequest. I don't want your gifts.
Well, the first one I gave you seems to be very fitting. That collar compliments your hair pleasantly. And the second one, which I've been hiding behind my back, you'll need. A walking stick. How else would you get around?
I can get around fine without one.
To tell you the truth, I didn't get it for you, but rather the castle. Why should it have to suffer at the hands of a clumsy blind? So you will take the gift. Or we can just kill you for treason and then burn down your old home. And I might add, I'll make sure everyone is still inside.
Fine. Thank you for the gifts, Your Highness.
You are most welcome, madam. And to answer your question from earlier, the guards are not permitted to enter where we're going. They've never, nor will they ever step foot inside its walls. It's strictly classified.
Well, are you authorized to tell me what this place even is?
A laboratory.
Just like in the song. So after a long, long day, they fly high into the trees to their little beds. But they have to do it before it's too dark, or they'll get lost.
Well, what happens if they get lost?
Then the mommy bird gets really, really scared because she loves her baby bird so much.
So does the mommy bird ever find the baby bird?
She doesn't have to. The baby bird never stays out too late.
Ugh, shit. What time is it? Perhaps one day my life could look like a late-night rerun of an I Love Lucy episode. There's a part of me secretly wishing that waiting for me on the other side of that door isn't the always expected empty room. Hell, I don't expect a surprise party, but it would be nice to be acknowledged by things other than the TV set.
Well, the middle of this nation is a big wet mess, as Fox reports tonight. Another line of storms pushing through, slamming just about every state from north to south. with heavy rains, fierce winds, and in some cases, floods and tornadoes. Take a look at how widespread this is. Wow, the area in red and the area in white where severe storms swept through earlier today or are forecast to strike tonight. The heavy rains straining several levees, including here in Poplar Bluff, Missouri.
I live in a tower. I don't know whether to call it a prison or a haven. I never felt like I belonged. I was that puzzle piece that you can never find a place for. I frustrated the hell out of you. When I was younger, I used to conjure up this image of monsters clawing up the underside of my bed, ready to pull me by their scaled talons into some sort of abysmal underworld. I mean, kids did this all the time. It was normal. Except, they didn't welcome these nightmare-inducing thoughts. They weren't like, "Whisk me away! Take me to your leader!" They cried. And then eventually got over it. Maybe I'm not so normal.
Wow. This place is remarkable.
How would you know that?
It does smell a bit like rust, but it sounds like a symphony. I can hear the water rattling the pipes, and something metallic in all different notes playing the melody. A steady march of a machine. Something bubbling and then the steam whistling through the cracks. There's this ticking, keeping some sort of broken beat. And all these sounds are blending together, playing off each other, and finally bouncing off the walls in an echo. How big is this place?
Big. Really big. However, this isn't the opera, so at my request, don't break into song. I will kill you out of sheer annoyance.
Alright, I'll try to refrain. So, what's my job?
You really couldn't hear the footsteps.
Wait, I thought you said no one was allowed in here.
Not particularly. Archie!
What does Master Talon require of his worker?
Well, this here is your new partner. She will be working in a control room, managing the rest of the comrades. Her job is to control the water flow, monitor the EMW levels, rewind the gears, and at closing time, reset the others.
Your Highness, what is this?
Oh, my apologies. You see, Archie, this ugly scrap is blind, meaning she can't see a damn thing, so she doesn't understand that you are just some metal and wires, meaning you're a robot.
My components consist of a titanium outer shell to protect the programming system that turned the gears beyond my head. I am mostly fueled by electronic current similar to that of a human's. I am Model 243, but am referred to by name. I am the architect, overseer of Project X.
Hi.
I am pleased to make your acquaintance, female. Please state your rank so I may file you into my resource directory.
My rank?
Agname, agnomen, alias, appellation,
what?
Autograph,
the machine
autonym,
wants to know
brand,
your name.
Cognomen, oh. Compilation, denomination.
Epithet, my name is Orisa.
Orisa. Filing Orisa into resource directory.
Ah, so that's your name. It's a bit of a dichotomy, seeing how someone gave a beautiful name to such a disgusting face.
You're so sweet.
Orisa, you might want to be a little kinder to me.
I apologize, Your Highness, for my rude remark.
Thank you. My feelings feel less hurt. I can't have my assistant bad-mouthing me.
Pardon?
Well, you see, my father's out on business, so that threat you made earlier was rather invalid. However, my duties lie in this laboratory. You see, I just don't have the time to be playing around with this chemistry set, so I needed an employee. Someone who wouldn't speak out against what they saw, someone who couldn't see, didn't have a family, and someone I could trust. Those qualities are particularly hard to find amongst these villages, so I got rather lucky when I found you. I was going to build another robot who could suffice, but that would have taken a very long time.
I'm your assistant.
Did I stutter?
This means we'll have to spend time together?
Not quite, so you can stop holding your breath. I will come and collect you every morning and night until you start to learn your way around with elevator, but I'm not sticking around here. This place is acrid. I have better ways to spend my time.
When you say that, what do you mean?
With my time? How is it any of your business?
My friend, Tay. Don't hurt her.
Ah, yes. Well, I'll be going. I'll see you later this evening. The machine will give you the rundown.
Your Highness, did you hear me? Please! She can work with me or in the kitchen. She's an amazing cook. Prince Talon!
I heard you. I'm just not listening.
You know, you really look beautiful. Are you going to say anything anytime soon? Perhaps a thank you? Sweetie, you can't change your fate, nor did you ever have control of it. My rotten good-for-nothing father is a farmer. The crops did bad last year, and my family had less money than a dead man's pocket. So, my father offered his eldest, the only girl in a family of 8 boys, though if my mother wasn't dead, she'd never allow it. Still, I fit the prince's appetite. The prince fitted my father's pocket with gold, and everyone went away happy.
You can't possibly be happy.
Ugh, there's your voice. It's pretty.
How can you say you're happy? How does this prison delight you?
Well, we are always fed. We're given comfortable chambers, and the prince isn't an eyesore. He's handsome. More handsome than any husband you would have had.
I can't do this. I don't want to do this. I just want to go home.
Honey, this is your home now. Listen, you stay in bed, act sick. I'll take care of it this time. Trust me.
I believe today I get the pleasure of trying out my new conquest.
Your Highness, fancy seeing you this afternoon.
Yes. Did you prep the new one?
See, she's a little sick, if you know what I mean, and won't be able to perform today.
Sick?
Sick.
Ugh. Well, that just sucks.
Well, I'm still here, Your Highness.
Hmm.
Why don't we move to your chambers? You can play with her another day.